You are listening to the Wisecracker Podcast.
I think the last time I had nerds was probably longer ago than having nerds rope. I think I've had nerds rope more recently than I've had regular nerds.
The nerds packaging is the original paper straw. Because I don't know how you're supposed to eat. They never show you in Willy Wonka the movie.
No.
But
no, there's not enough demonstrations of stuff going right in Willy Wonka. They show you everything going wrong, but they never show you how you're actually supposed to.
A lot of complaining. Not a whole lot of problem solving. You drank the fizzy lifting drink. Maybe you should have put a fucking warning sign to not drink the fizzy fucking lifting drink. Or did they? I think maybe they did.
Did they make them sign a contract before they...
You couldn't read that shit. It gets smaller and smaller. Remember?
Yeah, but it's still legal.
And then they taste it.
And then they taste the contract.
It gets to the very bottom, and then when it's signed here, it's like, it tastes like matzah. Well, they walk just like,
that's that part of the tour.
Yeah. Slugworth.
The litigation room.
come in here, and no court in the land will side with you if you drink the fizzy lifting drink. Wonka, you know Wonka's got those German, those Austrian courts in his pocket.
Yeah. I mean, that's why he was allowed to have slaves.
Yeah. It's all experimental. It's all fucking tied together. The Nazis, Willy Wonka. That's why World War I started, was because they fucking Slugworth threw a fucking hand grenade at Willy Wonka.
It was the Slugworth-Wonka dispute that... kicked the whole thing.
No one really knows why World War II or World War I started.
It was a chocolate war.
It was a big chocolate war.
Over candy distribution.
And that's why the Germans got so upset after it, because they love chocolate so much and they lost the chocolate war. It's got to be a big kick in the...
Really demoralizing. The
I feel like most Wonka shit's not chocolate. Like, this is
Wonka. Most of it's... nerds.
Is this not Wonka anymore?
Is Laffy Taffy Wonka? Did they take the Wonka branding off everything?
Did Willy Wonka
finally get canceled for owning slaves?
Willy Wonka's finally done. For the shit he did to those kids. I know that we're making a habit of letting people off easy for fucking with kids. We're looking at you.
Not Wonka.
We're looking at you. Actors. Politicians.
Yeah, if you want to fuck with the kids, it's got to be in your factory.
Yeah, at least build a fucking big factory to fuck with the kids. I guess
and
they
at least teach them a
that.
Lesson. Well, I guess they. I'm not gonna get into.
Come with me, and you'll see a bunch of kids on my own private island. Fly with me, you will be. Charlie. A big Hollywood star.
Charlie, it's called the Lolita Express. It can fly any direction, up, down, sideways.
If you want to view paradise, simply step on my plane in New York JFK Airport and you'll see. It doesn't matter if you're on Saturday Night Live or the President of the United States. Come on, my kids.
Come on me.
Come on me. Yeah. Damn.
Make it pee. Okay. Monkey pox will never stop this orgy.
Damn, that Twitter thread was brutal. Like, hey, I know there's a disease going around.
It was all capped with, like, it could happen to anyone.
It could happen to anyone.
I got monkeypox. It could happen to anyone.
Anyone.
Anyway, I was at the piss orgy.
I was at the 20-person piss orgy. Well, the first one, he was like, yeah, it was a birthday party. And we knew everyone. Everyone was from in town. And yes, it was 18 people, and we all fucked each other.
Mm-hmm. As you do. I couldn't resist.
I couldn't resist. I couldn't resist. But then the second one, he was like, but then Thursday rolled around and you know Thursday is piss pig. just
Thirsty
as Taco
Thursday
Tuesday.
For piss.
It could happen to anyone. It's like, I trained my whole life. I'm 7 feet tall. I trained my whole life. I played basketball from sunup to sundown every single day of my life. I didn't even go to school. I practiced every single day, and I won the NBA dunk competition. It could happen to anyone.
It really could.
No, this is your whole thing. You've been practicing being gay.
It can be,
It
can be a guy who has sex with hundreds of people in an orgy setting. It can be a dog's anus. It can be a young boy. Anyone can get monkeypox.
Yeah, this gets soggy. The paper, because I don't know how you're supposed to eat it. Because
you're putting your mouth to the Nerds box. That's a double. The Nerds boxes used to be like a pack of cigarettes or something, right? And then this
smaller.
One's like a double wide.
The Nerd box.
This is like
started.
A carton of Nerds.
Yeah, let's see. This is 5 ounces. Hey, yo, let me get 5 ounces of Nerds. Hey, yo, dog, how much is 141 grams of Nerds? What's the street price for 141 grams
What's
of Nerds?
What's a serving size these days?
We need safe injecting sites for everlasting gobstoppers.
Well, if we could give them the everlasting gobstoppers, they'd never have to do what they do to get more, because it would be everlasting.
Maybe you should be gobstopping this dirty drug habit you have.
You sign the contract. Just say no to fizzy lifting drink.
Yeah, they used to come in those little, the real little ones, like the Halloween ones that you would open it up and you just shoot it. It was like
shot.
Yeah,
Nerd shooters.
And then they would do it where they'd have a bigger one, like a cigarette, and it had on both ends. Those tabs would get soggy. Mm. The milkshake I drank had a paper straw. That got soggy. I'm usually with the libs on the paper straw.
Was the tab for airflow on the pack?
Yeah, it's so that you could shoot the pack fast.
Shotgunning the pack.
There were two different flavors. There was like a pink and a purple. There was a lemon and a lime. Which if you're going to the store, if you're like, Candyman, can I have a lime and a lemon? Any candy? You should get put in the fucking furnace of the chocolate
sour
factory.
Sour apple,
no questions asked. Well, sour apple's not that bad.
I don't like any of it.
You don't like any green?
I don't think I like... Here's the problem with Nerds and all this shit.
You don't really like candy.
I don't really like candy.
Yeah.
There's something about like the colorful fruity candy or like sour candy. I don't really like it. I like chocolate.
They mix them all up here. I like the I
like
the
chocolate,
I like the
and I will die for chocolate.
You're sounding dangerously like Slugworth over there.
Why did we lose the chocolate wars? We are chocolate.
We invented the chocolate.
Finally, chocolate for the people.
We need
Willy Wonka.
We need pure alien, pure dark chocolate.
Or milk chocolate.
Chocolate. No, Germans hate milk chocolate. All Europeans hate milk chocolate. That's like a very American thing. Because we poisoned them. Because we went over there and liberated.
Mm.
Back when it was liberated and was sick.
They were trying to make good chocolate. And no.
Milk chocolate is because we would have the Hershey chocolate and we'd go over there and give it to some fucking Belgium kid that just saw his mom get blown up by a fucking
German
tank. They give him one single square of the Hershey, because it's like, you know.
Here you go.
And then you give the father a cigarette.
This will help.
You give the father a Marlboro Red, and then you give the son a Hershey, and you get them hooked, and then they're in Western, they like America for the rest of their lives. They're locked in.
Mm. They need the Hershey.
Because in that time of trauma, it's like, you know, anything's good. It's like if you have sex when you're having trauma from having sex. You end up liking that type of sex.
No, I don't think that's true.
I'm kidding. That scared the shit out of me.
They attacked you for saying that.
Sorry about that. That's going to be an annoying thing to edit out. We watched Elvis. Dog shit movie.
Yeah, okay.
We watched Elvis, so
now
you don't
have
to.
Our weekly Willy Wonka segment is over. Let's move on to
we can talk about
movies
Willy Wonka all
recently
day.
Watched.
Might as well call it the Willy Wonka podcast.
Elvis. I was hoping Elvis would be more like Willy Wonka.
Yeah,
teach
Elvis,
some lessons.
Elvis was like no movie I've ever seen or movie I ever wanted to see.
It was so quick right from the get-go. I understand why the TikTokers like it.
Yeah.
Because it was 1 second cuts for the first half
hour
of the movie.
We were, what's it called? Intoxicated, and we were watching Elvis, and boom, boom.
Yeah,
the first, it's the fucking and the cuts, and not in a good way. They have split screens. There's 17 different things happening on the screen. None of it's good. All of it's Elvis shaking his fucking cock around right. for those teens.
Right.
Come with me. yeah, junk. Really, really bad. The singing was good. The kid did a good job singing Elvis, but I feel like anyone can sing Elvis.
Yeah, it too much about the Tom Hanks character, too.
Got caught in a trap. I'm on a plane, but I do not love kids, baby. Why can't you see? Jeffrey Epstein's not my friend. It was just a career opportunity.
How can we go on together on suspicious flight logs?
Suspicious flights. And my career will be fine because they're not coming after any of us. All that the kids have fucked. All right. Not everything has to be about pedophilia, Mac.
No.
There are other things to talk about, like the economy and gas. And gash. The gas, the gash, and the grass.
Sam is a trap.
I'm not trans. I don't know.
He is a man. The dress does not make him a lady.
I got my hair cut today. I look like I'm a troop. I look like I'm Elvis going into the fucking service. We really could talk more about Elvis.
Yeah. I just don't really think I have anything positive to say.
You were talking about the interesting things. Talk about the fucking Nixon.
There's
stuff.
A bunch of Elvis cool stuff that they didn't put in this. According to this movie, Elvis is one of the most boring men who has ever lived. For some reason, I don't think that's true, that Elvis is one of the most boring men who's ever lived. And then you hear actual interesting stories. Like when he just showed up to the White House one day and was like, I want to meet Richard Nixon. And they were interviewing him and stuff. And he was like, I just want to talk to him. And like, he kind of got...
Who are you, bud?
I don't know how many rounds of the interviews before they were like, wait a minute, this guy is Elvis.
Yeah, were there a lot of Elvis impersonators back then, or did that pop up after?
I wonder.
I feel like the impersonators probably started after. They like Elvis so much, they're like, I need to be him because he died too young.
Did that
happen with Heath Ledger Elvis Joker is... too?
Maybe.
When someone dies young, they kind of become like a legend in a way.
Yeah, I think they started after his death, probably. Hmm. But he was, so they had to make sure he wasn't just an Elvis impersonator, I guess. But then he got in there and he was talking to Richard Nixon apparently about how he knows about the communist infiltration of the music and entertainment industry. And he's watching out for it and like, and you, don't worry, you got a man on the inside.
John Lennon called him a right-wing southerner.
Well, according to this story, that might be true. And then apparently he wanted to get like deputized. It was like one of his life goals to get this badge to be like a deputized drug enforcement agent, which is also funny because it's like, oh yeah, Mr. President, I know about the drugs. I know
what
everyone's doing.
Keep your friends closer than your enemies. That's what they say.
He definitely knows where the drugs come from. Elvis knows how to get drugs, so he knows where they come from.
Mr. President, if there's two things I know about, it's playing that rock and roll and it's doing them drugs.
So he gets the badge, I guess. So he became like a deputized.
He gives him like a little
law
plastic
enforcement agent.
Fucking star. It just says DEA
on it.
It's
a gold sticker.
Oh, here you go, Elvis. Keep singing that good music.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much for this communist killing license. A license to kill communists.
Elvis, why don't you start? I like that. You gotta start singing music the white way. Stop dancing around on the stage like a fucking fairy.
Well, no, the cape is actually very straight. And that was the other thing I wanted to talk to you about, Mr. President. You should be wearing more high collared with jewels on it. Because it's for straight people now.
There's a lot of weird stuff.
Gay hasn't been invented. It's the 70s.
We don't do.
That's the other thing. Elvis thought he was like a perfect. He was Steven Seagal before Steven Seagal, apparently.
Oh, yeah?
He thought he was like perfect at karate and stuff, even after he was Fat Elvis.
Well, that's how it happened. That's how Elvis started. Was Elvis was singing and he was just like, I'm singing. Here's the song I'm gonna sing. I'm from Memphis. I'm gonna sing this song. And then Elvis's best friend B.B. King was like, Nah, Elvis, you got to put a little thug in it. You got to put a little thug in it, Elvis. I like that we're referencing a movie. All right, so put a little thug in it, Elvis.
All right.
So when we were for Max's birthday,
just referencing a movie,
we saw and here's the thing: we saw two movies the past week.
Big movie cast.
One was Elvis, maybe one of the biggest movies of the year.
Yeah, I think it's gonna.
And
win
then
some
the other movie was a movie called Half Past Dead, starring Steven Seagal and Ja Rule, the rapper Ja Rule,
and the actor.
I'ma kick you.
Until the night.
You expected somebody?
It all went wrong.
Special Agent Williams, FBI.
It's a nice night to die.
Now, they're serving hard time.
Welcome to my island.
In the most feared prison in the country, the new Alcatraz.
What are you packing?
This.
Ooh. You wanna play rough?
Sorry, I'm not into men.
And their biggest problem isn't breaking out. It's dealing with the guys who just broke in.
Let's party, boys.
You all right?
I'm all right, man. We got issues.
Any word from Alcatraz?
One of the cell houses was compromised.
How many hostages?
I've got 10.
Why are you doing this?
I'm gonna dig up $200 million worth of U.S. gold brick, taking early retirement.
What's your cause?
My cause is me. See, I'm sociopathic. Means I can kill everybody in this room and not feel bad about it.
What's going on?
We got a problem.
How do I look?
Like a big fat prom queen.
That's your game plan.
You watch my back.
All right, homies.
Two things can happen. You get killed or you get caught. Comprending?
Sweet dreams, partner.
Comprende this!
Hit the block. Hit the slave.
The inmates.
Make the game.
Aren't taking any prisoners. Goal. Morris Chestnut, Ja Rule, and Corrupt.
What's the matter, girl? You don't like me?
Click, boom, bang. Hit the rock, spit the game, bang. Get the clock, spit and flame. Do my mother. Bang, 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 bang.
Half Past Dead.
I'm a bang. Hit the block, pitch the slang. Bang, hit the rock, spit the game.
The movie starts off with Steven Seagal being recruited by a terrorist organization to jack cars, and they put him on a lie detector test.
I missed the first 10 minutes of the movie, so the title didn't make any sense to me.
Right.
I was waiting for something to happen that made sense, but you said at the very top of the movie he is dead and they bring him back to life.
Spoilers, but he takes a test. What's it called where they hook you up to the lie detector?
A lie detector test?
Yeah. Oh, polygraph. He takes a polygraph test, and the guy's like, are you CIA? And he's like, CIA? Do I look CIA gay? And Ja Rule was like, this guy's good.
Ooh. You want to play rough? I can play rough.
Sorry, I'm not into men.
Because him and Ja Rule are boys.
This guy, I.
Yeah, he's definitely I. They're I off screen before the movie even starts. And then he's like, are you FBI? It's no more games. I'm mad at you now. Are you FBI? And he's like, no. And he passed the test. He is FBI, though, we find out. So it starts off, I guess that he's there to jack cars. Again, we were intoxicated. I don't know if I'm going to get this right. He's there to jack cars. He's with Ja Rule. They jack a car. At a certain point, he pulls up to where they need to drop the car off. He opens the door, skids out. Throws Ja Rule out of the car.
Yeah, Ja Rule like gets dummy. Thrown from the passenger side window.
If this
of a
movie
car.
Wasn't called Half Past Dead, it would be called like Ja Rule Thrown.
Stop playing, man.
I'm a bad man, you know that.
Stop the car.
It would be called whatever that like movie technique is where they kind of like pull a guy back and then move the camera to really make it look like he's flying.
Yeah, like they spin people like a top and throw
yeah
them in
whatever
the, air.
The name of that is, that should be what this movie is called.
That's not even what happened here. Steven Seagal literally just does like a J turn, and then the door, Ja Rule's passenger door, opens up and Ja Rule flies out, lands on the windshield of a car, rolls off. Steven Seagal gets out of his car and Ja Rule's like, man, I ought to kick your ass. And that's it. They're still friends. He attempted murder as like a joke. It would have killed him. It would have killed in any kind of reality. It would
but
have
that's
killed
good.
Him.
I like when they set the like the base reality for the movie early. Like,
but the thing, halfway through the movie, which, and I'm jumping around, but they're in a prison and they're all in jail and some of them are trying to escape, and there's a hit team squad trying to kill a different prisoner. At a certain point, Steven Seagal picks him up and throws him into a glass case, and it kills him.
Oh, right.
It kills the guy. And he threw his best fucking...
The logic of the movie is a bit
inconsistent. His best friend, he threw him into a fucking windshield through
a
moving
car. But here's the thing.
Car.
He didn't go through the windshield. He went out the open window and then flew half a block and landed on cement and other cars. And he was fine. But he didn't hit any glass. So this guy who was thrown into the glass window, he hit the glass and he died. Because glass is poison. He got glass poisoning.
Oh, we got glass.
Glass
poisoning.
Is what is deadly in this movie.
Oh, okay, that's aight.
It's not the fall. It's not the impact.
Make sure that's okay. Hit the, just unlock it.
It's glass poisoning.
It's glass.
That these guys are suffering from.
They're so. When they're in the car, they're having a conversation, and at a certain point. And again, the dialogue in this movie is so abysmal, it's even hard to remember. But at some point...
There's also not as many payoffs in the dialogue as you'd hope. They set stuff up, but it doesn't always pay off.
There's
one,
and it's the biggest payoff in movie history. Ja Rule... Steven Seagal does something... Probably, I don't know, throw Ja Rule out of a fucking moving car into another car. And he says, are we all right? And Ja Rule's like, nah, we ain't all right. We aight. And Steven Seagal's like, what the fuck did you just say?
Are you speaking English to me right
what
now?
What the fuck did you just came out of your fucking mouth, Ja Rule? And he's like, now you try it. You gotta put a little thug in it. And Steven Seagal with his fat, puffy, fucking alcoholic Russian vodka face is like, what? And he's like, nah. Look at my lips. Aight. And then Steven Seagal's like, I just don't think I can do that. And Ja Rule's like, shit, you wetter than I thought.
I like Nicholas, all right?
No, it's not all right. It's all right. Put a little thug in it. Maybe you get your money.
I love Nicholas, all right? Was that good?
Nah. Check it out. Read my lips. All right.
How was that?
You see the way I'm doing that right there? You see where I'm getting that in there?
That's tough for me.
The thing is, Steven Seagal didn't take his advice when it came to language, but he did put a little thug into it because Steven Seagal's wearing a do-rag for the rest of the movie.
So, okay. There's a shoot-off. There's a standoff between FBI, which we now know Steven Seagal's in, Ja Rule, FBI. Steven Seagal... He's an agent, but he's on Ja Rule's side. And this woman, is dual wielding pistols at Ja Rule. And Ja Rule's like, I don't talk to no pigs. Right. Mm-hmm. I'm about to put a little thug
keeps
into this.
Keeps saying it's a good night to die. Too.
Yeah, he keeps saying it's a good night to die. And Steven Seagal's like, no one needs to die tonight. And then they get in a shootout. Steven Seagal gets
Steven Seagal's
shot.
Whisper gets quieter and quieter.
By the end of the movie, he is literally like, I'm so glad we caught all the bad guys.
And then at the very end, he's not even talking.
Oh, okay.
Well, yeah, I won't get into what really happens at the very end.
Because I'm going to explain this whole movie. Fuck it. Code of Honor. So, or no, that's a different
one. It's not Code of Honor.
That's a different one. Code of Honor.
It's Half Past Dead.
Half Past Dead. So Steven Seagal does get killed. He gets shot. And then they resuscitate him. They do CPR on him as he's bleeding out. Mm-hmm. And that's how that happens twice in this movie.
Yeah, he does that to another guy who is riddled with bullets. Yeah. And he just like kisses him, and then he's alive.
He uses a stun gun to shock him. That wakes him up. Mm-hmm. That's so funny.
Oh,
that
yeah, he wakes him up with electricity.
When someone I know dies, like gets riddled with bullets, I'm going to go down and be like, I'm going to put their hand in a toaster and like kiss them.
Jump
and their body's
their
just going to get burnt and fucking like violated sexually. And I'm just going to be like, I saw this in a Steven Seagal movie and I thought that I would bring my friend back.
Yeah, what happened? Usually we tell doctors and nurses to fuck off on this show.
Yeah,
but now I'm asking a question. And if you know the answer to this, please contact us. If you have a bunch of bullets or metal in your body and then someone uses... shoots electricity into you, does that fuck you up?
I guess if your heart stops, you can kickstart it.
Yeah,
that's what that song's about.
That guy was half past dead.
That's what you're supposed to, when you're doing CPR, you're supposed to do staying alive. But for when you have to shock your friend who's covered in bullets, and you have to be like, and then once the drums come in, doom, 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 and then you shot the shit out of them. That's how you kickstart someone's heart. So that's good. That's important info, like useful knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, but he dies, and then he gets back to life.
Mm-hmm.
And then cut to him in prison. He's wearing a do-rag. Mm-hmm. And spoiler alert, he doesn't take the do-rag off.
Is that part of the prison uniform? Because a lot of the guys in prison are wearing like hats and stuff. Is that just part of the prison uniform?
Oh, maybe you have to cover your head?
Yeah, maybe.
Oh, big.
At Alcatraz 2.
Yeah, that's a big part of it. The rest of the movie takes place on New Alcatraz, aka Alcatraz 2.
Alcatraz 2.
It's funny. I was explaining this movie to a group of other people, and they seemed so uninterested.
Well,
so I wonder.
Hopefully, our podcast audience doesn't feel the same way.
So
we could talk about Willy Wonka again.
I'll speed it up a little bit. There is a person that has $200 million worth of U.S. gold brick,
and they
never refer to it as just like there's this gold bars off the coast of San Francisco somewhere. Every time they say, we have to find them $200 million worth of U.S. gold brick. As if it was like legally, that's what they had to say.
Well, it could have been
the script.
$200 million worth of U.S. gold leaf or something.
Yeah,
gold.
But U.S. gold brick.
Gold coins.
So what happens is the guy that stole the $200 million worth of U.S. gold brick is now being put. He's being executed. He's on death row for stealing.
Oh, that's what was going on. Because that was the other part of the movie I missed.
Yeah.
I didn't really figure out who
that
guy
was. No, the bald guy is put on death row for stealing
for
from the
stealing
federal
gold
government. So think about that next time you try to steal from the government.
Yeah, think about that, Trump.
Yeah. And so what happens is that a Supreme Court justice... A woman she is there to oversee, even in the movies, we can't escape this fucking bullshit. You get
Supreme Court, we gotta put a little thug into it.
Can we really afford another thug mayor? Another
No. No, we can't. That's my favorite thing that we're not gonna talk about that.
No. So the Supreme Court is there to oversee the execution of a thief. And there's only maybe seven. Does that or really eight happen?
When you get sentenced to death by the Supreme Court, which is what they do, do they send the Supreme Court justice to watch you die?
Yeah. Justice Kavanaugh is going to be there when I ironically get the death penalty for stealing $200 million worth of U.S. Bud Light, U.S. Coors Light. He's going to be like, you disrespect... I don't remember what he sounds like. It's already been...
That, probably.
Long. You disrespected the beer. And now you must die, Mr. Naismith. And so what happens is another... a group of terrorists breaks into the prison and they kidnap the Supreme Court justice so that the guy getting executed can get out so that he can show them where the $200 million worth of U.S. gold brick is.
Right.
But Seagal is undercover. Oh, and I should say, when Seagal is brought into prison, Ja Rule's there, and he's like, you're alive. And he calls him the N-word.
Ooh.
A bunch. He calls Steven Seagal the N-word. After trying to get to teach him.
Well, in his defense, Steven Seagal is wearing a do-rag.
He is wearing a do-rag.
Wondering if my nigga want to slip me from ear to ear. You're my man.
But I would like to be in the writer's room, because it took a village to make this fucking beauty. I'd like to be in the writer's room.
No single man wrote this film.
Or woman.
Or woman. It took the collective minds of many great artists.
We don't have any phones. I would like to look that up. This is really kind of a good test for us, because we're constantly needing to look things up and shit. Mm-hmm. And for the past two, since we've been using them to record...
I do get into a habit where I use my phone as at least the other half of my brain, if not the other three-fourths of my brain.
Uh-huh.
And it's probably a bad habit.
I can't visualize pictures anymore. Images, like when I close my eyes and I try to think, it's just gray.
It'll be all right.
I don't see colors anymore unless it's on my phone. Like, if I look around, everything's just kind of
gray. The world
gray.
Is so dull.
And then when I go onto TikTok or when I'm watching Elvis.
It's bright
it's
and euphoric.
Beautiful. Everything is shooting. All the
I was
dopamine.
Tingling when we were watching Elvis.
Yeah.
I what was the other thing about that I hated? Hard. It was really just that they made Elvis so boring.
Yeah, well, there was a point. We got to finish.
Okay, let's finish
it's
talking.
It's almost done. It's almost done. So at the end of the day, they fail. The Supreme Court... Justice is kidnapped with the guy who knows where the $200 million worth of U.S. gold brick is. Cut to the bad guys have both of them, and they're flying in a helicopter right above sea level. Steven Seagal pulls up in a helicopter with his FBI friends right alongside them. And also at the beginning of the movie, when you meet Steven Seagal's character, the bad guy's like, so you're Sasha. And he's like, it's like, you're from Russia. It's like, I'm Russian. You have a problem with that? And they don't talk about it for the rest of the movie. It's just like a quick little, like, you got a problem with me being Russian?
You got a problem with me not standing with Ukraine?
And he's also in the FBI.
Are we going to have a problem?
Are we going to have a problem with me not hanging a Ukraine flag outside my house?
Am I going to have to take you down with just hand movements and a very stiff, fat body?
Yeah. Oh, man. He's already... This is like 92. Oh, no. This is 2002.
This was definitely 2002 or something.
Because you could tell 9/11 had a little bit of an effect on this. Because they probably started shooting after and released it just within months. So their helicopters parallel to each other. One has a Supreme Court justice... seemingly a good guy villain who's a thief, and then the terrorist bad guys that are there for the $200 million gold brick, U.S. gold brick. And Steven Seagal's like, and this is over the helicopter noise, two helicopters.
Not the Supreme Court justice.
Because this is 2 hours in the movie, so he's at a full whisper.
You gotta let her go, man. No one needs to die tonight.
And so... what ends up happening is the terrorist is like, I'm going to kill this bitch.
I think he says
I'm going to kill this honky bitch because he's also black. He's not Ja Rule.
Very confused by that.
It's confusing.
It was very confusing the entire time. I was like, is that the bad guy? Oh, no, that's the good guy. That's the one of the good guys. And I was like, is that Ja Rule?
Is this kind of Durag the good guy?
This is a big part of it. The whole movie doesn't have like a score. It just has a soundtrack, and it's all Ja Rule songs.
Right.
And these are not like the classics.
They cut in. Yeah.
So at a certain point, helicopters flying parallel, the terrorists push the Supreme Court justice out.
Mm.
Cut back to Seagal's helicopter. He's already got goggles on.
He knows
he says,
what to do.
I got her. Don't worry, I'll save her.
Don't worry, I'll jump out of this helicopter.
He jumps out of his helicopter. It cuts back to the terrorist helicopter, pans over to the guy who initially,
yeah,
the bald
guy.
White guy who stole the $200 million worth of U.S. gold brick. He's got a bomb vest on.
Mm-hmm.
And then,
I didn't see that one coming.
And then their helicopter explodes, and then Ja Rule's like, here we go. and the music's like, and then fucking Steven Seagal jumps out of the fucking helicopter.
After the Supreme Court justice.
All of a sudden, they're 30,000 feet in the air.
Because this drop lasts
seconds
forever.
Ago, they were, I don't know, 90 feet above the water. And they are falling for 2.5 minutes.
Sometimes helicopters fly at the altitude of a commercial jetliner.
Seagal catches her. Movie over. Beautiful. Seagal knows where the $200 million worth of U.S. gold brick is because the guy told him. Seagal takes the FBI there. He's finally gets the do-rag taken off. He gets the do-rag.
That's how it's discovered that he's a cop. He takes that off, and it's like, holy shit, you were a cop the whole time.
He gets the do-rag forcibly removed by the Federal Bureau of Investigation.
They have to surgically remove it.
It's like face-off.
It was a surgery that they did
to
put
him in there. We have to make you look like a criminal. We have to somehow make you look like a criminal.
Using our advanced medical technologies, we will disguise you as a criminal to go undercover.
And so Steven Seagal goes back to prison. Ja Rule's very mad at him because he's a fucking pig.
Mm-hmm.
So he's behind glass, and Ja Rule picks up the phone, and he's like, man, what'd you do? Come here to arrest me again, pig? He didn't say that. That actually would have been better dialogue. Yeah,
I can't remember the dialogue for sure because it's bad.
It's really bad. Like, none of it. But leading, so the whole movie where like it has to pay off at some point. The nah, man, you got to put a little thug in it. Mm. Aight.
The one meaningful conversation they had with each other.
At a certain point, they are behind glass, and Steven Seagal is like, I traded the $200 million worth of U.S. gold brick for your freedom, Ja Rule. And his name's Ja Rule. It says, and Ja Rule's like, man, yeah, hell yeah. Like, and Steven Seagal's like, are we all right? And Ja Rule's like, nah. We ain't all right. We aight.
Let's go.
Like, your smile, your kiss. Love it when you look at me, baby. And then credits roll, and they fucking have just like an improv scene between
two
black
characters.
Yeah,
then the best scene of the movie is an improv post-credits scene.
It's legitimately funny. Like, skip the movie. Well, actually watch the movie. It's amazing.
Yeah, watch Half Past Dead. But if you
it's
don't want to
Netflix.
Watch it, just fast forward to the end credits scene.
The end credits scene is genuinely very funny. Like, it's a funny just skit. And
it's like one of the guys from prison just
and his fat girlfriend
getting visited by his girlfriend.
Yeah, it's really good. It's like they literally filmed it and they were like, fuck, we have to put this in the movie. Someone in the writer's room of Half Past Dead had like a good head on their shoulders and were like, we have to include this somehow. But it's
you know
great,
what it
it's
was?
Hour and a half.
That was probably
by.
Steven Seagal, the filmmaker, because the problem is he's in the rest of the movie, so he can't direct and act. It's tough to be behind the camera and in front of the camera.
Yeah.
But for that scene, he's not in there, so he could be the total behind the scenes creative. And that's why that's the one scene that's good, because Steven Seagal's not in it. But not for the reasons you think it's good, because Steven Seagal's not in it. It's because it was his idea. Maybe.
But yeah, I feel like.
Yeah, Elvis should have been more.
So
like
that bit we did at the beginning, like an hour ago, where B.B. King says Elvis needs to put some thug in it. That's a reference.
Oh, yeah, that's what it was about.
Got a little bit off track. We can get back to Elvis. There was a really weird thing that happened in the movie. Martin Luther King died. And
yeah, what was that all about?
Elvis is so distraught. He's like, Dr. King always told the truth. And Mac said, blurted out, he didn't call him Dr. King.
I don't know if Elvis called him Dr. King.
Dr. King.
I don't think anyone called him Dr. King
back then.
I think they called him the Reverend Martin Luther King Jr. Reverend King.
That's what the good people called him. The bad people called him something really bad.
But now the bad people call him Reverend and the good people call him Doctor, I believe. Because Doctor is better than... I don't know. Because if you say Dr. Martin Luther King, you can pretend that he's like a vaccine doctor, like one of the good guys, not one of the bad guys, like a religious doctor.
Yeah.
Which is what he was.
That's what he was. He was a religious doctor in the Bible.
Doctor in theology.
He practiced biblical science.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of leeching and screwing holes in heads to get the pain out.
There's a reason he was having such crazy dreams.
Jesus probably set shit back medically because like they were doing stupid shit of like, you have a deadly disease. Well, fuck this virgin.
cool stuff. I get what you're saying. Stuff didn't work back then, but it doesn't work now.
Right.
So at least back then it was fun and cool, like getting leeched or getting to have sex with a virgin.
Yeah, at least back then it was like
drinking the blood of my enemies.
You have the virus of the Great Red River. Okay, well, fuck this albino virgin. And now it's like, oh, you have monkeypox? Just go to the piss party. Who cares? Just a couple little fucking sores. Now, I heard monkeypox is really bad. We don't need to talk about it. But, I have a feeling that they, like, someone, what was that? Zero? Around, like, 25? Someone must have been starting to figure it out. And then Christ comes along and he's just like, oh, you're blind? I'm going to put some mud in your eyes.
Do you mean because what he was doing worked?
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, he was doing magic, and I think that might have fucked up some people.
Maybe.
Because it's like, oh.
People, I see what the problem is. Jesus was going around using miracles and his God abilities to heal people.
His God
and then
power.
That got us thinking that we could also heal people.
Maybe.
But we can't. And all of medicine is a lie.
Oh, no, that's not what I meant.
I get what you're saying.
Possibly. I don't know. I'm trying to think. I guess I got rid of my herpes. But that was through prayer just as much as through any kind of medication.
Belief.
I just had to
through belief.
I had to put some thug into my...
Yeah, the most you see Elvis in this movie in his private life is like him watching TV.
He watches a lot of TV,
and they only show him shoot a TV one time.
For being the king of rock and roll, he really was a
he really liked
slave
being sad
to the television
and watching TV.
Could you click that again? I don't know why this is a new feature where my laptop turns off mid recording.
We're fine, we're good, we're in there. What were my other thoughts on that movie?
Dr. King,
can't remember, it all happened so fast.
Dr. King always told the truth except for when he would come home a little bit buzzed. Yeah, no, I'm loyal, baby. Do you think that's a smear campaign?
Elvis, someone has shot the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King. Which one was he?
Elvis, he's the most influential civil rights leader of our time.
My friend B.B. King is dead.
No, Elvis. No, it was Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King from Memphis, from where you're from.
Show me a picture of him.
All right. Him.
That's B.B. King.
No, Elvis. No, this is... Okay. All right. Elvis, we're laying it all out. Jackie Robinson. B.B. King. Martin Luther King.
Okay. I'm looking at three pictures of B.B. King.
Were BB King and Martin Luther King related? That's fair to ask. They have the same last. If there are two people named Nate, like, oh, we're both named Naismith, we're related.
When I was a kid, I could have sworn that Shaquille O'Neal and Jermaine O'Neal were somehow related.
Yeah.
But they're
not.
Who
was the other one? Ben Wallace, Rasheed Wallace? I thought they were brothers.
I kind of knew they weren't for
some
reason.
They don't look the same at all.
For some reason, Shaq and Jermaine. I was like, maybe they're cousins?
Both tall, hugely
are they
tall
not?
NBA centers. They're both Irish.
What if they are? They're both Irish?
Yeah, no, that was... I think I probably learned that in high school. That I was like, oh, yeah, fucking of course they're not. There was another one. I'm not gonna be able to remember, but I thought it was the son. It was an odd name.
Yeah, every once in a while you get that, like especially with sports.
Yeah.
Someone will be named like Babe Ruth Jr. and it's like not, but his dad is not Babe Ruth.
Well, it's like that artist, that fucking shitty artist when we were at the Getty. His name was named after a baseball player because his dad was a baseball player.
Ty Cobb.
I think it might have been he was named after Ty Cobb.
Oh, really?
I don't know. This, look up fucking shitty art from the Getty. This fucking...
Who was... The guy who really got in trouble with that was assuming that the one NBA player was another NBA player's son. Didn't the Wizards announcer need to apologize?
Yes, that's what it was.
For being like... But who was that guy?
I don't remember.
Well, then who cares?
But I thought that too.
Yeah, why would you not assume...
And I'm not apologizing for it. Yeah, it was like he can shoot just like his dad, just like his poppy. and people were saying, it's like, they're not related. It's not a son. It's like, oh, sorry that the guy that plays for the Wizards, he's wearing the same fucking number.
Also,
it's got the same jersey. And it's like, oh, I'm going to assume that they at least know each other, maybe.
What made it worse is I think his actual father was in prison for murder.
That was it.
Or something.
Oh,
like
that's
that
what he said. He said he can shoot. He can shoot.
He's a shooter like his dad or something.
That's what he said. And they got mad. But he thought his dad was the Wizards' great shooter.
We're gonna edit in what the name was right here.
No. I think we've already talked about it.
Yeah, we have already talked. We talked about this right when it happened because it was such a hilarious whoopsie daisy.
Definitely ended up on Shaq, in a fool.
Definitely.
Jermaine O'Neal in a fool. Jermaine Calm. Jermaine.
I know the Indiana Pacers have entered the stands, but Jermaine Calm.
Yeah, anytime an athlete freaks out on the... Welcome to my new segment called Jermaine Calm. You've heard of Shaq's and a fool. This is Jermaine Calm. Oh, Mason Rudolph is being helped up by his all-black offensive line, but Myles Garrett hits him in the head with his helmet while Mason Rudolph doesn't have a helmet on because he said the N-word, which is something a quarterback would do while being helped up by his all-black team. Myles Garrett, looks like you need to... Jermaine Calm.
Yeah, that would be a good segment. I think we need that segment right now.
I could bring Jermaine Calm on. Oh, this was something I learned yesterday because my sketch team was talking about making this intro video, and someone on my team said that you can rent. This is not the way I should phrase it, but you can rent Coolio. Friend of Ja Rule, I'm assuming. You can rent Coolio for $800 a day.
I don't want to rent Coolio. I only am interested in owning Coolio.
Cool. You can acquire Coolio's services for $800 a day is what I hear.
Does he put on a concert?
No, I don't know.
He just hangs out with you?
I'm not sure. I think...
Does he like cook you dinner?
I think he might show you how to do your hair like he has it.
Oh, maybe.
I looked up a picture of him now because he's like 56, and he's bald through the middle,
oh,
but
no.
He still has like the crazy braids on the sides.
I have always said that the real gangsta's paradise is being a middle-aged man in America.
Yeah.
I can't wait.
What are his biggest songs? Gangster's Paradise, the Monstars theme from Space Jam.
Oh, yeah.
Hit 'em high, hit 'em high. You hit 'em low, hit 'em low, hit 'em low. They never really show the Monstars locker. Oh, no, they do, because they have fucking Newman in there.
Yeah, they find Newman in one of the lockers.
Yeah.
And then what do they do? He shows back up and he's all burnt because they use their fire breath that they almost never use otherwise, right?
Yeah. When do they blow Newman up, though?
That's when someone sits on him and he gets flat.
Oh, and
but
then,
that's during the game.
Right. Yeah, the Charles Barkley orange.
And then that's when they're like almost out of players, right?
Yeah, because
they had to use Newman.
The movie really doesn't make much sense when you kind of talk about it.
Especially when you break down the in-game action of the basketball game that's kind of the climax of the film. Doesn't really make sense.
I think a guaranteed way that I could get myself mad is watching the new Space Jam.
Hmm.
Because I watched the first, I mean, this is, I don't know.
I like the part when Lola Bunny
this.
Gets pushed out of one helicopter and then Michael Jordan has to jump out of the second helicopter.
I got her. Hit him high, hit him high, hit him high.
I believe you. I can fly.
Yeah, R. Kelly. I wonder if he's in the new, does he have a song in the new one?
I hope so. Did they?
They really dropped the hammer on that guy, even though, I don't know.
He was just having a piss orgy
People
with
are still
girls
yeah.
or whatever was happening.
I used to watch Space Jam. I don't need to say the original. You know what I mean.
It's say Space Jam 2 when referring okay. to
I think Space Jam
LeBron
Legacy.
James, Space Jam.
Referring to LeBron's.
No, I'm pretty sure it's called Space Jam 2.
No, it's called Space Jam Legacy because LeBron James's legacy is that he's actually a choke artist. And no one ever really seems to talk about how he can't finish finals.
Space Jam leg cramp C is more like it. Remember when LeBron had a cramp? When was that?
That was
when they were in San Antonio and there was no air conditioner.
Oh.
Do you remember they had to play a June basketball game in San Antonio and the air conditioner was broken?
I didn't remember. I thought he just got
cramps. And then he got cramps and everyone was like, LeBron's a pussy. He's getting cramps.
101 degrees in an arena.
Yeah, it was like Texas. Texas in the summer.
I am the best athlete of all time. All
right. If there's a time
and I'm getting some cramps.
Like, yeah, whatever.
You fucking
pussy. Let the man cramp. It's not the worst thing he's ever done.
Jordan never cramped.
No, he didn't.
Now, what's the worst thing? I think the worst, number two worst things. Okay, so number three worst thing.
If LeBron James is outside of a hotel room without.
Hold on. Okay. The number three worst thing he did was Space Jam 2. The number two worst thing he did was The Decision. The number one worst thing he did was in a hotel room with the Wayne Wade in 2012. Look it up. Good luck. Good luck finding anything about that thing that we made up. Look it up. What's my source? I don't have one, bitch.
I did read one of those like Hollywood gossip blind items once that was like, this basketball star who wears the number three likes to wear his celebrity wife's clothing on the road or something.
Oh, who?
I don't know who it was.
Who? Is it the guy with blonde hair who has a trans kid?
No.
Or is it Allen Iverson?
I think they were talking about...
Is Allen Iverson married? Did he ever get
another
lockdown?
Number three. Yeah, he was married. Because remember, he had that hilarious thing where his...
I don't know where he is.
He had a thing in with his wife. His wife made him sign a contract that's
right.
like... we're going to like split up it, but if you do any of this stuff, I get like all of your money or
yeah.
something.
Did they?
And it was, I forget if they split. I kind of have a feeling they split. I see these, like DraftKings commercials or whatever starring Allen Iverson and his face looks like a divorced
man.
Oh,
he looks
to
like
me.
Newman after they blow him up.
Yeah, he really looks like a divorced guy. So I do think it didn't work out, but I think before he got divorced, they signed some kind of contract that was like, I just need you to not cheat on me, not gamble, not drink, not do drugs, not spend a bunch of money on this or that. And then he apparently went down the list and did all of it. And his wife was still cool and was like, even though I'm legally entitled to like take all of your money now, I won't do it.
I think she did leave, but she said, Alan, the answer, because that's what they would call each other. Alan, it wasn't the drinking. It wasn't the gambling. It wasn't the drugs. It wasn't the women. It wasn't the clothes. You made me move my ass to Denver. I had to go all the way to Denver. Baby, no, baby, don't leave me. We don't need to go to Denver. We'll go somewhere else. All right, better be good.
Better not be Detroit or Memphis.
Babe, I'm back. Babe, listen, I got a trade. Where are we going, Alan? We're going to Detroit. You motherfucker. And then she takes her shoe off and starts saying, yeah. Am I allowed to do that? Tyler Perry does it. Why am I not allowed to do it?
But take his shoe off and hit people.
Dude, be like a black woman.
Dwayne Wade's allowed to dress that way in private.
Yeah. Yeah, at least he does it in private now. DNT. Can you imagine that? The fucking... Can you imagine the fun that that Charles Barkley and the gang would have if he showed up wearing a dress? Charles They'd Barkley did...
Now
no.
Talk about Shaq and a fool.
Charles Barkley did say...
It's Dwayne Wade in a dress.
Hey, he thinks he's a woman, but he's really Dwayne Wade.
He's married to one Shrek. Of the most beautiful women of all time, Shrek. But he's still gay. I'm Shrek.
No, Charles Barkley recently had the thing where he's just like, if you don't like the transgender, fuck you. Which is like, yeah, that's more fun. That's fun.
Yeah, I heard Shaq say something like, oh, yeah, I made up that nickname for him. I called him the Flash because he used to flash me his dick under his dress on the road.
Yeah. What else did I have written down? I think that's pretty much all I had. I mean, I could do the fucking, we were talking about, I put in the intro last week, but just the clip of Trump just being like, Biden is he's a radical. He's as radical left as you can do. He's doing all the radical things. And we know this. He's against guns. He hates guns. He wants to take your guns. He's against God. He's against guns. And I just think it's so funny that literally both sides, the right is just like, these Democrats, they hate God, they hate gun. And Democrats are just like, these Republicans, they hate gay, they hate black, they don't want black to vote. And it's like it's just so funny. I love the like way of talking of just like that. That guy running for governor in Florida that's just like, democracy is trending, or he says gas prices are down, inflation is trending down, democracy is trending up.
Yeah, good news, everyone. Democracy is trending up.
My opponent is against democracy. He hates black, he hates gay. And then he goes and he's like, I would love to have Joe Biden come down and campaign with me, because Joe Biden, President Biden, he's doing an excellent job. He's doing the best job anyone's ever done, and he's a good man. He's a great man. As a matter of fact, he's the best man I've ever met, and I would be honored to have him come down and camp. It's like, what are you talking about? We can all agree Joe Biden is doing a great job. But to say he is the best man you've ever met, the guy is probably
best
a pedophile
man I've ever met.
The best.
Whoa, hey dude, let's cool it with the accusations.
Come with me and you'll see what it's like to shower with your nephew. All right, we don't know anything. What's my source? You figure it out. God, I like being back. It's good to be back to just accusing people of being pedophiles. I feel like we took a little bit of a too long of a break from doing
that. Yeah, there was a long break, but now we're back to the original stuff. 100 episodes, 101. We're now good.
We hit the Cruella.
And now we get back to playing the hits, accusing people of being cross-dressers and pedophiles.
We reset. The queen!
Oh, the queen died.
The queen!
Oh, yeah. Rest in peace to the queen.
Oh, bloody, the queen's dead. Cruella de Vil.
It's like those things where Chadwick Boseman is greeting Ruth Bader Ginsburg in heaven or whatever. But the British version of that is it's Jimmy Savile.
Oh, my queen! Welcome to British heaven, which is just a place to fuck kids.
Wait a second. If you're here, then... Oh, no, it's hot! Oh, man. Yeah, British heaven is... where it's there's like a river of just fucking like gravy slop, just like fucking potato.
It's a river of baked beans.
baked bean slop. That's just a river that everyone just like. Oh, this is proper fuck.
But there's
good,
no pints. Oh, that's heaven. I thought you were describing hell.
No, that's heaven. Oh.
Yeah, in heaven they get pints.
Yeah,
hell is that. There's but no, there's no
there's
pints.
No pints. British hell is like, welcome to the Crest toothpaste factory. You have to brush your teeth every day. Yeah. At least once every
is
day.
Is that what it is? British people really
no.
hate the dentist. Oh, bloody
no. Bloody no.
Yeah. Most of the reason I talk this way is because of my fucked up teeth.
Yeah, man. The queen. I like the queen now that she's dead.
Now that she's more of an idea of the past.
I don't know.
I always used to say a thing where if I saw a member of the British royal family, it was on site. But now there's people that are being kind of weird about the queen and they're being like so anti-queen.
Yeah.
That now I have that thing in me where I'm like, wait a minute. Maybe I like Queen. Maybe I like the Queen.
You know,
but
it's
I don't.
Interesting.
I don't. I just don't hate her as much as these people do.
Long live the Queen. That's a phrase that we're not going to hear for. Who's the next? Because this fucking old guy's he's not going to be
what
around.
What is he at? So we get a king for probably 6 months, and then we'll see what happens.
Yeah. Well, who's next in line? I hope it's that
really
hot
know.
Actress bitch.
Yeah, I hope it's one of the hot ones.
That light skinned. American Beauty. She takes over and she's like, actually it's makeup.
And then everyone changes the way they talk like the queen who's using an American accent.
I think that would maybe happen.
Maybe
people they hate them.
I always heard something about the modern British accent, which it is like based on people like mimicking the aristocrats or something, and that the American Southern accent is closer to the original British accent.
I've heard that the founding fathers,
the King of England, used to talk like Elvis.
Yeah.
George Washington always told the truth.
That was just Stephen.
Yeah, that's
Seagal.
What I'll miss.
That was Stephen Seagal.
That's what I'll
Sorry,
miss
got,
about the queen
confused.
Is she always told the truth.
Yeah. Now she seemed cool. I guess her legacy is kind of cool. She lived for like 90.
Dr. Queen.
Dr.
Elizabeth.
What's her
queen.
Name? Elizabeth Warren.
Elizabeth Warren, the Queen of England.
I don't remember her
at
name.
112.
Queen Elizabeth, but what's her like name?
What's her queen?
Her first name's not Queen.
Her first name's Queen and her last name's Elizabeth.
Queen Elizabeth II. Oh, that was a funny thing too.
Her middle name's Elizabeth and her last name is II. Her first name is Queen. Sorry, was.
On True Social, I went to post a picture of Ruth Bader Ginsburg, the Queen, and Hillary Clinton, and I said two down, one to go.
Yeah, big news.
Very,
I'm still using Truth
very
Social.
Very cryptic. Very rarely, but yeah, follow me on Truth. Retruth me. And Trump had an apology.
Speaking of always telling the truth.
Dr. Naismith always told the truth. Dr. Naismith always told the truth. That's it. I was doing Seagal that entire time. Dr. Naismith always told the truth. Donald Trump was like, the queen is dead. She was great, sexy girl. I loved her.
I had her.
She was great. And I really, it's sad. It's a really sad day. And then, but the thing underneath it was like, the frauds and the pedophiles of the Lincoln Project are back on, guess what? Fox News.
Is like, that why we're back to accusing people of being pedophiles?
Because our leader told us to do it. Our boy telling us
the
to
man
do
we steal all our ideas from, all yeah. our good ideas.
He really did pollute my brain Donald in a bad way.
J.
Even the way I talk has kind of shifted to be more like him.
Well,
I love that guy.
It's interesting. I love that I'm guy. I'm gonna try to be more like Elvis, but the real one, not the gay fake one from the movie.
Not the Twinkie.
Not the one who was always sad and like didn't make any of his own life decisions.
No.
Yeah, right. Like Elvis was bound to some contract. They had a thing going where the Colonel was a gambler and he was a drug addict.
The Colonel's a good man. Okay.
Also, where's our Colonel? I want a Colonel to find this podcast and be like, the what? That's my show, and I'm going to make sure I make a lot of money off
that
this show.
That video gets likes. They just roll in from random people that aren't like, oh, this is a funny clip. I should listen to their podcast.
What do they think it is?
I don't know.
Just a clip from the movie?
Yeah, I don't know. I did team up with Baz. What kind of name is that? Also, this movie was kind of anti-immigrant because they're like, Colonel, your name's not even Colonel. It's,
oh, right.
It's Gustav Wiener Schnitzel.
Colonel, are you some kind of Jew?
Are you some kind of German Jew that fled Nazi Germany and now you're trying to make it here in the United States? That is simply
unacceptable. That is illegal in America. This is the 60s. It's illegal.
It's illegal to be a fat Jew in show business. God, thank God that's not still the case for people like me. I'm not saying I'm ethnically Jewish. I'm not religiously. Right.